welcome to Odyssey Media's Business Sanctuary.
Hello, I'm here in Atlanta doing this series called Passion to Purpose. Women who are passionate about a cause or an issue and they turned it into a business. I'm here with Tashai Henry, who I know from New Jersey, who now lives in Atlanta. Why did you decide to do a trucking company?
Well, as you know, I started out as an attorney, and my husband, when I met him, worked as a union member, and he had already had a CDL license, but he was working for a company. And after we had my first daughter, we wanted to expand, we wanted to grow, and we realized that owning a truck, our first truck, we could have more time together, and he could get his own contracts, and he could definitely have more time and be more lucrative in the business.
Well, one of the things I hear constantly from women who have this passion is, I stepped out on faith. I believed in my husband. We knew that we could do it on our own. But Tisha, I have to ask you something very personal. You have 5 children.
I do.
And you and your husband work in the same business?
Yes.
And how is that working for your family?
I will tell you, I absolutely love working with him because we have so much in common, so much to talk about, and we have passion about another thing, not just our children or each other, but we both have passion for the business. And so it's not like it's always wonderful, passion, you know, fun. We do have disagreements about it, but it's just something wonderful that we share. It's just another thing that we share.
I think that's awesome. So did you write a business plan? Did you just, he came in one day and said, that's it, I'm starting my own company. You said, baby, let's do it. Or did you plan? How did it come about?
Did not write a business plan, mm-hmm. but my husband is very social. Mm-hmm. So while he was working, he would talk to other truckers. And then he would start to find out that, okay, this person owned a truck and this person worked for a company. This person had contracts. So we started exploring it ourselves. And, you know, it's not one of those businesses where, you know, people say, well, you have to be in it for a year before you started making money. Because once you deliver these brand new cars, you're getting paid for what you did. So we just jumped out there on faith, mm-hmm. and we went in 50-50. And we split it, and we decided to operate it together, and we've just been operating on just our experiences since then. Now, expanding has been difficult, mm-hmm. and we need a plan for that.
Very good. So what I'm hearing from you and working with your husband, it's fun, it's passionate, but that only goes so far. And if you decide to expand, you absolutely have to have an expansion plan that's
Correct.
Written down. Trucking used to be sort of your old uncle's kind of business. It's hot again. What attracted you to trucking and not something to do with being a lawyer?
Well, you know, once we realized that this was a specialized field, mm-hmm. so there are, you know, wonderful truckers who can drive freight and deliver it, mm-hmm. but then what my husband does is auto. So he takes brand new cars from manufacturers,
wow.
and you know, when you're buying your brand new car, there cannot be one scratch on it,
mm-hmm.
and they have to load it, unload it, and deliver it, and a lot of people are not willing to take that risk.
Got you.
But with high risk, there are higher rewards than the other industries in trucking, the other, you know, different divisions.
Did you start this business to get rich?
No, we did not. We started to take me out of the workforce to plan a family.
Okay.
And it was a way, it was more lucrative, but we were not thinking, oh, we're going to get rich, but it was a financial decision for our family.
Wow, so you're one of the first to say, for work-life balance, we decided basically that you could do the books at home and then he could manage the trucking. That's a pretty good partnership decision. So listen, I'm a futurist, everybody knows it. I'm always into what's coming next with disruption. I just read about Tesla's self-driving truck. Are you afraid of robotic trucks or self-driving trucks Could that run you out of business?
Our industry is specialized. Mm-hmm. And, you know, we think about that. We've thought about that. But to unload cars, in addition to just driving it, they're going to need some other robots to do that. So, you know, until then, we are thinking about it. Mm-hmm. And, you know, as parents, we also push our children in that direction mm-hmm. to learn coding and other things like that. So, you know, we can be right there with them to know how to segue into that.
Is it hard to get financing and credit in the trucking business?
Well, credit is king, and especially in trucking, because the equipment is so expensive. It's a small house. Mm-hmm. And so, you know, they don't expect you to have cash to expand. They want you to have good credit, a great history. So we've been in business since 2008. And you have to have a great DOT record. Mm-hmm. So it's also your record, that driving record in history.
Wow.
That, you know, people are willing to then say, well, okay, because you could not get this equipment without the specialized license, without a great experience, and the credit. So that is one of the best ways to expand. And of course, if you have cash, that will never hurt.
Well, I have to tell you, every entrepreneur I have spoken to, the first thing they say is credit is more important than cash. When I was coming up, they said cash is king. But now, like you said, there are specialized regulations and policies,
correct.
But people want to know who you are. And I say that to all the young people that watch our videos. Don't walk away from your phone bill. Don't drive and get DUIs and carry on. Those things have consequences when you get ready to open a business.
Absolutely.
And that was really an important point. The last point I want to ask you, which I think is very important for people to watch, do you get any private time? So here you have 5 children, you work with your husband, you're working from the home part. I mean, is there any shy time? I might just run down the highway screaming if I had to work with my husband 24/7 with 5 kids.
Yes.
How do you take care of you?
I will start that tomorrow. It's always the answer.
Right.
No.
Okay.
No.
Thank you for your honesty, because everybody says, oh, I go to the spa, set a day aside.
No.
You're like, no, with 5 children, there is no private time in a business.
Correct.
Is it worth the sacrifice?
Absolutely.
That's what you want to hear.
And the future of expansion, you know, when you have goals, you can see it coming down the pike,
mm-hmm.
you know it's worth it.
Very nice. And so let me just leave with this. What advice would you give to other women that want to get in the trucking industry? They may want to invest in their niece or nephew. Maybe they have an uncle that's been driving trucks forever, but he needs to get to the next level. You don't always have to own the business to invest in the business. What advice would you give?
My advice would be, 1, to do not jump out there without experience. You have to work for a company and learn just driving experience first.
I cannot tell you how important what you just said is. Your credentials and your credit matters. Tashai, I am so happy to reconnect
Thank
with you.
You.
You're going to be on stage in Atlanta. Women can't wait.
I'm
a lot
excited.
Of people want to buy a truck for 2 kids in the family. I'm hearing from you, that's not the way to go. Make sure they have credentials, a great driving record, and good credit. Thanks, Tashai. Thanks for being here.
Thank you, Coca-Cola 5x20 Initiative, for all that you do for women around the world and your commitment to small business owners. Thanks again for watching.